I'm here to tell you. I'm gonna spill everyone's secret, so I hope you're ready. I'm not good at intros. Hello. Okay. So I've been doing a lot of YouTubing, and by that I mean I've been looking at a lot of videos, I've been watching a lot of different people. I've been doing a lot of research because I'm going to be honest, I have no idea what I'm doing with my life. And in the search of clarity, in the search of answers, in the search of direction, and in search of some sort of guidance from other people and, you know, energies out in the world, I've realized one very clear thing. And I've realized what everyone actually really wants. There's one thing that everyone wants, and I'm here to tell you. I'm gonna spill everyone's secret, so I hope you're ready. Everyone wants to be fearless. Everyone wants to let go of fear and the things that hold them back, and everyone wants to desperately be brave enough to follow their dreams. And I am for sure 110% one of those people. I want to be fearless. I want to be the next Nathaniel Drew. And I don't mean I actually want to be him. Like, I'm not shaving my head whatsoever. I've worked long and hard to get my hair as long as it is. So that is definitely not a thing. What I mean by that is I want to be brave enough to live my life with no backup plan. And if you're unaware, Nathaniel has a second channel called No Backup Plan. Basically, it's his way of saying that he's living his life day by day and going all in into the present moment. And I love that because I think it is so brave. I think it is absolutely courageous to live your life and go your day and go day by day not having a backup plan, not having a plan B, not having something to fall back on if plan A or what you're doing in the present moment isn't going well. I want to be like that. I want to live in the present moment, and I don't want to hold myself back from following my dreams just because of fear. I am scared of failing, and I am scared of not being strong enough, and I am scared that if I follow my dreams and I don't resort to having a plan B, then I will be shit out of luck. I'm scared that I will not amount to all of the things that I set myself out to succeed in. I am afraid that I will not live up to my own expectations, and I'm afraid that I will let people down. And I'm sure that this is not just something that I experience or can relate to. I'm sure a lot of people feel this way. And a lot of people make certain decisions in their life in order to avoid the uncertainty, in order to avoid the what ifs, and if this doesn't go right, well then at least I know I made a safe choice. And here's the problem with our thinking. Here's the problem with this mindset. And this is why so many of us are unhappy and continue to be lost and in constant search for direction. And just a tangent. I know I'm not the only one that has looked up videos on YouTube that are titled, "What to Do When You Don't Know What You Want to Do With Your Life," or "What to do when you're lost," or "How to figure out what you want." Like, I'm sure I'm not the only one. So many of us have done that, and maybe you found this video because you looked up something similar. What I'm trying to say is that the problem with us relying on a backup plan, the problem with us letting fear control our life, is that we are not living our life to the fullest. We are not living life in the present moment. We are constantly thinking about the future and what we could do better and what steps to take. And we're obsessing over planning, and we're obsessing over the details, and we are stressing ourselves out sick trying to figure out what the best decision is. And I could probably make a whole video about this next thing that I'm going to talk about, but I'll just touch on it briefly because it is relevant to myself at the moment. But I think about how many people choose to go to school and put themselves through thousands and thousands of dollars in debt just because school at least provides them a direction. Because when you go to school, you have things to follow. You have assignments due, and you have rubrics, and you have syllabuses, and you have all these things that you can follow that give you an idea of how to succeed in that particular area or subject or project or test or whatever. And when you get out of the school system and you are suddenly thrown out into real life, you realize there is no rule book, there is no rubric, there is no syllabus, there is no assignment list. You really are bound by your own definitions. You are bound by your own assignments, if you will. You are bound by your own way of thinking, and suddenly the rubric that your teacher assigned you is now replaced by your own expectations and your own perspective about what your life should be. And because so many of us are ruled by fear, we set these goals and we set these rules based on that and not on what we actually want. We are so consumed by the fear of the unknown and by uncertainty that we make decisions based on that and not on what actually fuels us and makes us want to live. And quickly, I'm going to throw a trigger warning just because I am going to talk about something that maybe might trigger someone out there. But if what you're doing currently, or if the lack of following your dreams is causing you to not want to live, then that's a problem. And that's something that I am starting to realize within myself, is if I'm having these constant negative feelings about life because I'm not doing things that make me happy, because I'm stressed about the future and I'm trying so hard to think about what the right thing to do is, what is the point? Why am I doing that to myself? Why do we do that to ourselves when what we have right now is the present? There are so many things, there are so many decisions we can take right now that lead us to a happier state of being and a happier way of thinking and a better way of living. And yet we don't do that because we are so focused on, well, what if I just go to school because I think that's the right thing to do, even though it's not what I actually want. And I've thought about that a lot because I'm currently in a place in my life where I have to make a decision about whether or not I want to go back to school or whether or not I want to just live my life and figure out a way to survive and still make ends meet, but somehow be in the present moment and truly, truly just live and not worry about being a certain person and professional and having a specific title. And I'm coming to terms with the fact that I searched for these things because I needed something to move me forward. I needed something to force me into moving on with my life and doing something with it. I have turned to school for that guide. I have turned to school for the rules. I have turned to school for a reason to keep going. And now I'm realizing that that is not the way to do it. That is not the way to go about life. I should not be going to school just to have some sort of direction and some sort of sense of purpose. I should be going to school because that's what I want to do, and because what I'm studying is going to lead me to my ultimate goal in life. But here's the kicker. Here's the thing. I don't know what that is. I am being so honest, and I feel like I have to do it because there's no point in lying to myself. I don't know what I want to do. I always knew that I wanted to help people. I always felt this need to save the world when I was a kid. I always felt like my purpose in life was for something so much bigger than myself, but I have yet to figure that out. And I've desperately tried to be a good student and put myself through all of these situations that could have possibly made me better and well prepared to face whatever next goal I have and whatever next project I put myself into. But I realize that I am not actually fulfilled, and I have been doing these things just to have a direction, just to have something to move me. And it has never been my own. It has always been what I thought I had to do in order to be happy. And that is the problem. We are choosing these things instead of following our own desires. And we are choosing to let fear control our lives. And that is our problem. That is why we are not happy. That is why we are not doing the things we want to do. And what everyone wants is to be fearless. That's what I'm learning. I've watched so many videos and heard so many people's stories, and so many of them are really motivating. I can't tell you how many times I've heard someone talk about how they finally figured out what they wanted to do, and I've had both this moment of being motivated, and then suddenly I have this moment of, well, how do I get there? How do I do that? They make it seem so easy, and yet here I am stuck and confused and lost, and I don't know what to do. And I think it's worth giving yourself time to figure that out instead of forcing yourself to do something that you think is going to get you there. I think what I have to do is stop thinking and just start doing. I need to start doing things that make me want to live, because that is ultimately what matters the most. If you're doing something that doesn't make you appreciate your life, and if you're choosing something that doesn't really fulfill your soul, then why are you doing it at all? Why are you choosing that over your own happiness? And I just want to say that if you are going through this in your own life, and if you are stuck between making a decision, and if you are driving yourself crazy thinking about all of the possible ways to make your life better, then I'm here to say that you need to give yourself time, and you shouldn't force yourself to do anything that you think is going to be better for you if you know deep down inside that is not what you want. Our gut really is our second brain, and I highly believe that if we feel something is not meant for us, we should trust that instead of relying on the fear and what other people might say. And yeah, I think that's all I have to say for now. If you're new to my channel, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe so that my channel can grow. And I hope you have an awesome, awesome day.